guys, I am Tristan Rand of Nocturnal Films. I've created what I think is one of my favorite products I've ever made. This is the Nocturnal Films Battery Depot. I'm gonna go over a few things before I get into the majority. It is a NoCo snap top battery box, which means it is a marine size 24 through 31. And that means it has an adjustable center. I'll get to that in a minute for your battery size. I have attached a door handle with four screws, bolts on the other end of it, and casters to give it a little bit more mobility. And for our prices, I'm going to have a little counter on our bottom right, or bottom left, I haven't chosen which, of what this is all going to cost. I did not say this is a budget battery box, but this is one of the best ones you can make. It has a lot of uses outside of filming. $8 for your battery box, $4 for your handle, $4 for your set of four casters. Keep in mind, my lighting is currently just set with the extension cords coming from my house. At the end of this, we're going to have it set where it's going to be running just from this for our lighting. We remove our top here. We have some very interesting contents, which I'll show you. Okay, so we got some few choice items in here to make this a better product. Our majority our money went into this SLA battery. This is 22 amp hours. Let me get it out for you to show you. This is our divider I was talking about. It goes exactly to that size of the battery. 22 amp hours. Get it offline. $42. It's proven very useful so far. Have my NoCo battery charger. I can actually keep this in a different location, but I just have it in here just for simplicity's sake. It's a trickle charger, so you know it'll keep a battery's life very lengthy. I actually keep a spare phone charger. I keep everything organized with binder clips. And a generic USB outlet from when I had an iPhone 5 years ago like a dumbass. And the meat of this is bolted in is our Bestech power inverter at 38. So the way this product works is you hook it up to a car battery or a SLA battery, does not matter which. As such, and then you just fire on your power button. Has a very low noise output because with fan running to keep its heat down. You plug in whatever you need to use and go. Now, as for the uses of this product, well, first of all, it's going to power my film lights for when we're in an abandoned area. We're wanting to use an abandoned school, so don't worry, we checked, it's legal. And also, you could also use it, like I said, I have a phone charger in here, so, I mean, there's nothing wrong with having a mobile power source. I actually got the phone charger idea from Tech Hole Productions. He made a DIY battery bank very similar to this. I'll put a link to this in the description. I actually was already in the process of making this when he posted it, which was completely mind-blowing. I was going to use a car battery and ended up taking his idea of using an SLA battery. This could run a fan at night for probably about 8 hours at very low wattage. What I've done with the whole 22 amp hours thing is that gives me the ability to have my lights on for roughly 7 hours. That's counting the inefficiency that an inverter can provide. It'll be about 7-8 hours before it hits 30%, just to ensure the battery life. And this Bestech energy inverter actually cuts off when its battery power hits 20%, which is fantastic for saving a battery. It keeps it, it's originally set for, if it's set for a car battery, it'll keep it from going dead for you. So to me, it's all thanks to this. That's some damn good water. I also keep my extension cords in here, but I've kind of already have them in use right now, so I can't really show you those. I also keep this wound around, it's just your basic tie down ratchet. I got this for $3 at a flea market today. This is actually my last piece I was wanting before I made this video, and that's just to go over the top, because otherwise little snap tops are not able to support the heavy ass weight this supplies, and it will actually just pull right off. The lid won't stay connected. With this, it ain't going anywhere. This holds up to 1,000 pounds capacity. It's not going anywhere. Without further ado, I think I'm just gonna cut my lights, plug them in, and just show you that it actually works. So you should not be able to see a damn thing. It is completely dark out here, and without ado, there you go. It has like a 1 second delay before the power reaches it. Take a look. yeah, there's my mobile light source. I don't think I have anything else for you today, except that you should subscribe. You should also check out Techo Productions. He also makes some awesome DIY stuff. And just for things that I have coming, I should have already posted the second part of the Razor Chronicles by now. That should have been up on August 20th. If not, it'll be up on August 20th. I've also got a review for a camera stabilizer, a newer 437, I believe. I got the name wrong. I know the newer part is the correct name. I'm not entirely sure of the full name, though. Have a cool tip to have a cheap crane slash jib, which averages about $5 to purchase. I'm going to be doing a review for an on-camera light. It's just a small LED light that you mount on the bottom of your tripod or camera stabilizer and goes out from the camera for a third light. Yeah, that's all I got for you today. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, just like any other generic YouTuber will tell you. Be sure to check out my other stuff. I've got plenty of DIY stuff here, and I've got more to come. And also be sure to give my short films a look. Give me any positive criticism you can. Negative works as well. In fact, I'm sure negative is probably a little bit better.